हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे वील डिस्कस समथिंग टू डू ऑफ योर रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द आंसर। योर नंबर क्वेश्चन नंबर वन फर्स्ट, ओके यू जस्ट रीड। मोस्ट साइटेड पीपल बिलीव दैट ब्लाइंड पीपल नीड अ लॉट ऑफ हेल्प। By answering the following questions, you will understand that blind people can lead a normal life. Give one reason in support of each answer. So student, here question asking about the blind people, how they need lot of help from you and you can help. That is written. You have to write in your book. In question number A, can a blind person walk without support? Yes, sometime. They can walk without support. Okay, then you have to write. In question number B, can a blind person talk? Yes. In question C, can see he eat on his own? Yes. Question number D, can see he listen properly? Yes. In E, can see he read with the help of a special script Braille? Yes. Can see he write? Yes. List three important points that you will keep in mind if you take a blind person to a market. You have to write in a book. So this thing you have to do. First one, I will help the blind person to cross the road. Second, we should take care of them. Third, we should not let them go alone anywhere. Then in question number two, visit a blind school. Student, your school never blind. This is wrongly mentioned in your printed or whatever you put me. Wrongly, I think, mentioned. A school never blind. So, we should not say like this, blind school, deaf school. That means school not deaf. School is not blind. School for blind. Yes, school for deaf. This we can say. So, here visit a school for blind, we can say. It only written, visit a blind school. So we should not say like this. We should say, school for blind, school for hearing and speech impaired children or an old age home. Watch carefully how did the visit sensitize you to their needs. Okay, you have to write here. Visit a blind school means school for blind, a school for hearing and speech impaired children, or an old age home. You just carefully watch and how the visit sensitize you to their needs. That you guess and write. Suppose I will say old person are living in a home and they need some groceries or goods from the shop or kirana store. Then how they will get it? If you are there, then you can help them by going to market or the shop to bring some daily needs for them. That type of help you can help them, or they need you, that you have to write. Then question number 3, good touch, bad touch. Your touch can convey many things. Okay, this is very much important. Touch can convey many things. You like the touch of some people, but the touch of some people makes you uncomfortable. Yes, everywhere, every moment, we cannot touch to anyone, because sometimes this touch may lead to uncomfortable. So here, good touch and bad touch mention. Share with your family members if you have come across a bad touch. What did they tell you? If there is some bad touch, then what they will and how they will react, you have to write. Suppose we are touching some uncomfortable part of the body or unwanted touch, then definitely they will feel uncomfortable and oppose you. This is bad touch. But sometimes good touch. Suppose if a blind person is crossing the road and at that time you are holding the hand of the blind people to cross the road, that is your good touch. But somehow, somewhere, this is happening bad touch. So it was your last last part of the answer, something to do of your second chapter, that is sensitivity towards other. Today we have finished your second chapter also. Next we will go for the third number chapter. So for today, this is too much. Thank you and have a nice day.